Hello all, I, Dr. Nidhi Sharma from AISSMS Institute of Information Technology, welcome you all. Today I am going to give the demo on the practical, which is based on estimation of total hardness of a given water sample by using EDTA method.
The objective, as you can see, the aim of the practical is estimation of total hardness of given sample of water by EDTA method. Now, what is the objective? To understand the complexometric titration, as this titration is also known as complexometric titration. And second is to understand the concept of hardness of water. Now, the water sample which doesn't produce lather readily, it is called hard water. Now, on heating, it leaves the scale on the container, which is called hardness. So, the total hardness is due to the presence of bicarbonate, sulfate, chloride, nitrates of calcium and magnesium. The relation between the type of water sample or degree of hardness can be given by the table. Like you can check whether the water is soft, moderately hard, hard or very hard. This is what happens when we boil the water. Calcium bicarbonate, magnesium bicarbonate on boiling gets converted into calcium carbonate precipitate, magnesium hydroxide precipitate. So this is what, as the boiling, with the help of boiling, we can remove the hardness. So it is called temporary hardness. And the hardness which cannot be removed by boiling, like the nitrates, sulfates, chlorides, these cannot be removed by the boiling. So these are called permanent hardness or non-carbonate hardness. Total hardness and permanent hardness is called, sum of temporary hardness and permanent hardness is called total hardness. This is a structure of disodium salt of EDTA. In this titration, we are using the disodium salt of EDTA because EDTA itself is not much soluble in water. And EDTA, disodium salt of ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid, it forms 1:1 complex with divalent metal ion. Now the theory is this: in complexometric titration, we use the EBT as an indicator. This indicator forms less stable wine red color complex with metal ion. As you can see, this is metal ion. When it reacts with EBT indicator, which is blue in color, it is going to form metal EBT complex, which is wine red in color. And hydrogen ion comes out. Now to arrest these hydrogen ion, as you can see, the reaction is reversible. So to arrest these hydrogen ion and to make the forward reaction fast, we have to keep the pH constant, the pH nearly 9 to 10. So to keep the constant pH, we have to add the basic buffer. So in this, we are going to add the basic buffer solution of pH 9 to 10. So by that, the reaction will always be in the forward direction. Here you are going to get the metal EBT complex. It is less stable complex. Now after that, we will start adding EDTA. Now, when EDTA comes in contact of this metal EBT complex, immediately there will be a formation of metal EDTA complex. And this complex is very stable as compared to this metal EBT. And the color of this metal EDTA complex is colorless. So finally, when it is colorless, so EBT gets free and it shows itself its color, original color, which is blue. So at the end point, you are going to get the blue color. What are the apparatus which are used in this titration? Burette, pipette, conical flask, beaker. The chemical which we need it: disodium salt of EDTA solution 0.01 molar, water sample, buffer solution of pH 10, basic buffer, EBT indicator, and 0.01 molar zinc sulfate solution. This we use for the standardization of EDTA. First we will do the standardization of EDTA solution. For that, we will take the 10 ml of 0.01 molar zinc sulfate solution. It is standard solution because the concentration of 0.01 molar, the concentration of zinc sulfate solution is known to us. After taking 10 ml from the pipette, we will take it in the conical flask. To the conical flask, we are going to add the buffer solution. So nearly we are going to add 5 ml of the buffer solution, half test tube or 5 ml. This is basic buffer solution. Basic buffer solution, it's a combination of ammonium hydroxide plus ammonium chloride. And to the same, we are going to add few drops of EBT, erychrome black tea indicator. It is going to give wine red color, and the wine red color shows that the metal EBT complex just get formed. Either it is going to form wine red color. Now from the burette, we have filled the disodium EDTA salt solution in the burette. From the burette, we will start adding the EDTA solution to the conical flask till we get the end point. At the end point, there will be a color change, and you are going to get blue color at the end point. We will just keep on stirring till we get the end point. This is the first step of the titration, in which we do the standardization of EDTA solution. Now you can see at the end point the color has come, the blue color. So this is the end point of EDTA titration. At this point we are going to note down the burette reading. As you can see, the burette reading is coming 8.1, nearly 8, kyunki it is a colorless solution, so we note down the lower meniscus, so it is coming 8.2. Now we are going to use the first equation for the standardization. Zinc sulfate is equal to EDTA, M1V1 is equal to M2V2. As for zinc sulfate, we have taken 0.01 molarity into 10, and EDTA solution we have to find out the molarity. Into X, the volume of EDTA solution used. So as in the reading you have seen titration, the 8.2 ml of the EDTA has been used. So you are going to put it into the formula, and the molarity is equal to 1 by 8.2 mole. Now the second part of the titration, to find out the total hardness of given water sample. To this, we have to do again the same process. We are going to take the 10 ml of hard water sample with the help of pipette. We will take it in the conical flask. Then we are going to add 5 ml of buffer solution into that and few drops of EBT indicator. On adding EBT indicator, either you are going to get wine red color or pink color. Then we will start adding the EDTA solution from the burette till the end point. At the end point we are going to get the blue color. You will just keep on stirring till you are going to get the blue color. Still it is about to come, as you can see. Yes, now the end point has reached. You can see there is a color change from pink to blue. We will note down the reading from the burette. The burette reading has come 12.8. We will note down this reading and we will do the further calculation. After calculating the value of molarity of EDTA by the standardization, we got the value 0.0122 molar. Then by doing the hardness titration, we got the value 13. Now on putting the value in the formula, total hardness is equal to Y into M into 100 into 1000. The Y is the volume of EDTA used in hardness titration, which is 13 ml. M is the molarity of EDTA, 0.0122 into 100 into 1000 divided by 10, which is the volume of hard water sample. So here the hardness has come 1585.66 ppm. So it shows, when we are going to compare the hardness with the table which we have discussed initially, so the water is very hard as the ppm is above 300 ppm. So finally the result has come, the given water sample, the molarity of EDTA solution in moles, it has come 0.0122 moles per liter, and total hardness of water sample has come 1585 ppm. So finally, the conclusion is the given water sample is very hard. So this is all in this practical. Thank you all.